Good boy. Einstein's here. Hi, everyone. Okay, let's see who's going to join us. Who's going to join us? Come on. Come on, everybody. It'll be fun. It'll be fun. It'll be fun. Come join us. Going to be fun. Woo-wee. Who is here? Hi, everybody. Who? I know we're a little bit late, but just a little. No, we're 5 minutes, about 4 and 5 minutes late. Sorry about that. Only 8 people joining us? 9 people? There's Billy. Hi, Billy. Billy's always here. She's so good. And there's Ella dancing. Okay, Einstein, what are you going to do today? You going to do some talking? Or are you going to do some preening? Peek-a-boo. Turn around. Turn around. Show everybody what you did to your football. This happened last night. Yep. No more squeaky football. No more squeaky. I heard its last squeak last night. And then he got quiet. And I looked and he was tearing it up. But that's what toys are for, right? I'm gonna have to take it away from him now. And he doesn't like it anymore because it's got this stuff in, well, it's got stuffing in it. It's got this pot. He doesn't like. Can y'all see that? Here. He doesn't like this polyester stuffing. And it's really not good for him either. I can't let him play with it. So, but no more squeaky. No more squeaky. No, don't get the iPad. This stuff. Yeah, you don't like that, do you? No, you don't like that. See? Yeah. So thank you, Kathy, for the toy, but it's a goner now. Okay, Rachel's here and Tammy's here. Angie's here. Marcia Barclay. Marcia, do you pronounce it Marcia or Marcia? I pronounce mine Marcia, Sha. That's how my mother always did it. So that's how I grew up, confused. Everybody always wants to call me Marcy or Marcia, which, I understand that. Hi, Sandra. Hi, Olivia. Okay. Before I get start, well, before we get started here, I just want to say thank you all for watching and commenting and sharing the reel I put out. Was it yesterday? Yeah, yesterday, because I haven't done anything this morning. The one that starts out training Jeff. And Jeff is in pink letters. Okay. That reel
It's not very long. Took me hours to do because I'm learning a new way to caption videos that's more entertaining. You notice there was a lot of, like when Einstein talked, it was down at the bottom, and then when Jeff talked, it was up at the top with an animal, a little animal gif or gif. And that literally took me hours to make, at least 5 or 6 hours. I didn't keep track, but I don't know that y'all are going to be seeing very more of those kinds of videos, but I really want to appreciate you guys watching it. Go back, watch it again. Comment, share, like, all that good stuff, because it literally took me hours to make. A long time. Anyway, thank you all. Also, people on YouTube, please watch it. It's uploaded to YouTube as a short, and it's called Training Jeff. It's real cute. Einstein's sitting there in the office with him, asking Jeff all of the animal sounds. And then Jeff does all of the animal sounds. It's really a cute reel or short, and I really appreciate it. In fact, I'll even put the link in the description of this live when I get done, okay? So I really appreciate y'all going and watching it and liking and sharing and following me and subscribing to me and all that good stuff. Really, y'all don't, it really takes a long time to make a video because, you shoot the footage and then you have to review the footage and then you edit the footage. And I mean, I enjoy doing this, but it takes a lot of time. And for about every minute of video footage, it takes about 5 minutes to 5 or 6 minutes to actually get it tinkered with and then uploaded for every minute. So, and that's really an underestimation because yesterday that was less than a minute. And it took me 5 hours. So it just all depends. But anyway. Yes, Billy, it's also on Instagram. So watch it. Yeah, it's also on Instagram. You're exactly right. I upload all my stuff to Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. So. Well, Deborah, she said she might have missed the one with the pink Jeff in pink letters. I'll post it again. I'll post the link again in the description. You can all go watch it. Well, it looks like Einstein's sleepy. Oh, Marcia Barclay, you pronounce yours Marcia. Okay. Okay, well, very good. I know that a lot of Marcias are out there. My mom just always pronounced it Marcia. My mom and dad. So that's how I grew up. Like I said, very confused. Because in school, the teacher would say, Marcia, call and roll, Marcia. Marcia, I'm here. Einstein needs a bedtime song, huh? Rock-a-bye, baby, in the treetop. When the wind blows, the nest will rock. Do-do-do-do, the nest will fall, and down will come Einstein, baby, and all. Okay, Einstein. Billy wants to know if you're really sleepy or if you're faking it. I think he's faking it. I think you're faking it. Okay, I'm going to go in here and do some work, Einstein. Oh, boy. I'm tired, too, Einstein. Look here. Here are your peanuts. Here's your Kansas City Chief peanuts because they are the champions. They are the champions. The champions. The champions. We are the champions. There you go. I need my microphone on. I don't have my microphone on. Okay. Einstein, you want to do some cooking? Want to cook some sweet potatoes? Corn. Broccoli? Sweet greens? See you later. Love you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Also, later this afternoon, I'll be posting a reel of yesterday's head bobbing slide. So be sure and be on the lookout for that. It has music with it, but safe music, hopefully. So it was real funny. Einstein did a slide down the shower yesterday. He bobbed his head along the way. It was real cute. This just might be a question and answer day today. Because Einstein really does look sleepy. He's been up a while, and he's kind of just been hanging out and talking a little, but he's... do you ever give him a bath with a spray bottle? Yes. And I'll show you the kind that we use. It's called a stylist. Watch his body language when I bring this out.
See if, yep, see, got his,
he got his attention. It's called the Stylus Sprayer. I get it on Amazon. Now they have them that are clear so you can see the level of water, and I'm thinking about buying a new one. But I like to use it on myself, too. I keep it full of water all the time to refresh my hair. But, yeah, it's like $10 on Amazon. There's a link in Einstein's Amazon store. And to get to that link, Einstein does have an Amazon store of all the things that I use and he plays with and I recommend or whatever. To get to that link, go to einsteinparrot.com/social. I'll post the link in a minute. And scroll all the way to the bottom and you'll see the little button that says Einstein's Amazon store. And then click on that. And then I think it's under the category things that I like. So I have several categories there. And here is the EinsteinParrot.com/social. Okay. Oh, Sherry, I really don't think he wants a bath. He's kind of in a sleepy mood. I wouldn't give him a bath now. It's obvious he doesn't. And the fact, as Lydia noticed, he did puff his feathers and he vocalized. He didn't. That means he doesn't really want a bath. But he also has his pool up on top of his condo. And he goes in there and bathes, usually at night when he hears the shower running. When we take our baths, he will bathe in there. So does anybody, if you're new, let us know. We're happy to have you. We call ourselves the Birdie Brigade. I don't know if Einstein's going to be, Einstein, do you want to do any talking? Yeah, we can certainly do a
drink of water.
You want a drink of water? Well, here's water right here. We can certainly do a question and answer episode. If anybody's new and has any questions, Einstein is 26 years old. We've had him his whole water. We've had him his whole life. And on that link I just told y'all about, einsteinparrot.com/social, there is a link to his frequently asked questions. There's links to all of his merch sites. We have merch on Redbubble and Teespring. There's a link there about the kind of diet he's on. He's on a very good whole foods diet.
Water,
yeah. I get some water toys out here. Where's Ducky? Ducky on the floor? Yeah, Ducky's on the floor. Let me get Ducky. Hold on. I'm moving kind of slow this morning. Pilates was pretty bad this week. She worked us over pretty good. Here you go. We are near Fort Worth. Fort Worth is probably the closest city, town in Texas that we're located, Fort Worth, Texas. Billy says, "Hi, I'm new to the stream. How many toys does Einstein have?" Billy has been with us a long time. Don't let her fool you. Lydia says he's 26 years, 8 months, and 7 days to be exact. Yeah, he was hatched June 15th, 1997. Billy, I can't tell you how many toys he has. It's an enormous amount. If you count every individual toy, it's in the hundreds, I bet. Oh, Elizabeth Marie had back surgery. Oh boy. I'm so sorry. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're getting better. Water. Okay, when he gets up there, his head gets cut off, doesn't it? Well, there, I'll back it up to there. Water. Let's get one of your goldfish bowls. It's in the sink. Oh, this one doesn't have holes in it, but I'll use it. Wait, maybe this one does. Yeah, this one does.
two toys in it. I can't get out. Here you go. Water, good boy. Okay, lots of questions now. I'll go through them. Does Einstein have a girlfriend? Yes. In fact, we had just had an episode of The Bachelor. We did it live. He had three girlfriends. Cosmo, June. Oh my gosh, my brain. Cosmo, June, and I want to say Gizmo, but Gizmo's a boy. Hang on. I'll get it. Sid. Cosmo, June, and Sid. These are other birds that we know on the internet. And we had an episode of The Bachelor, but he didn't give any of them a rose. He decided not to. He didn't even do fantasy nests or hometowns. He just decided that he loves them all and he wants to be friends with all of them. And so that's what we're going to do. We're just going to stay friends with all of them. Okay, let's see here. Has Jeff and I ever owned any other birds? If so, what kind? Yes. When I was a little girl, I was very young, 7 or 8, I had budgies and, the little parakeets. And Jeff, as a young boy, had a little pet robin that he rescued, had fallen out of the tree and he couldn't find the nest. And so he brought it in and he fed it ground up worms and things. And he named it Robbie. And Robbie lived with him in their home until Robbie passed away 8 years later. I think Robbie only lived 8 years, but Robbie had a very, very good home with them. Does Einstein like to get baths? Sometimes he does and sometimes he doesn't. It just kind of depends on his mood. He loves to have baths here in this bowl, but that's on his own accord. We don't, he does it whenever he wants to. His showers, we determine when he gets a shower and sometimes, well, he gets one about once a week, but we sometimes he likes it and sometimes he doesn't. I should say he tolerates it sometimes. Deborah, no, he'll never marry Cosmo. Unfortunately, those three grays also live in Canada, and we can't even go visit them. Einstein can't cross the border. The border is very, very strict on parrots and other. Einstein's considered an exotic. So they're very, very strict about that.
Oh, Diane asked, would he attack another bird if one came into his condo?
Yeah, I think he would. The condo is his territory. He hardly allows Jeff and I some time to come near it. Before the condo, Einstein was very, very attached to his apartment in the kitchen. He had a kitchen drawer in there. Some of the older videos you can go watch. I probably should post some of those older videos. I think y'all would enjoy those. I might start doing that. Some of you new folks that haven't been around long would probably enjoy some of those. So anyway, we had a visitor named Bibi the bird. Bibi's now passed away. She lived in Illinois, and they came down for a visit. And you can go watch the footage. Bibi came very close to Einstein's drawer, and Einstein was just a little bit hesitant about it. So if you do a Google search for Einstein Parrot Bibi, that's B-I-B-I. The video will come up. Einstein Parrot Bibi visit. The video will come up. Oh, Billy, that's a good idea. Billy says you should meet at the border on either side so you can meet up. Well, yeah, that would be that would be kind of a long trip to take Einstein, but from Texas to the Canadian border, that's a long trip in a car. I don't know, Einstein, would you like that? Yeah, Lydia, later in that video with Bibi, the parrots almost kiss. Yeah, it was cute. Deborah asked, what made your decision to buy an African Grey? That's a good one. 26 years ago, we knew we wanted a bird. We knew we wanted a parrot. We'd done a lot of research. And we had settled on an African Grey because we wanted a bird that we could interact with and that would be like a part of the family. There wasn't a whole lot of information about parrots on the web, but we read books and everything and learned that cockatoos generally are very feisty, but they don't really adapt well to a captive environment. And we also read, although macaws are very, very beautiful, they don't talk very well, and Amazons can be a little bit temperamental. So anyway, these are some of the things we learned about them. But we also saw a TV show about African Grey Parrots with Irene Pepperberg. And we knew that African Grey Parrots were very smart, and there's a chance that they could be good mimics. We just never realized how smart they really are. And now, because of the information that's on the internet, because of Facebook, you got to remember, 26 years ago, there was no Facebook. There was no YouTube. There was nothing. And so we learned as much as we could about parrots, but we didn't learn everything that I know today. And it's a continual learning process, too, with parrots. Today, I can now say that no parrot does well in captivity. They don't truly belong in captivity. Rescues are filled to the brim with parrots that are not wanted. And they all need for good forever homes.
homes that will take them in and treat them like a member of the family, as we really always have with Einstein. And I know that there are lots of good parrot owners out there. But, you know, just as there are good dog and cat owners, there's also a lot of them that do suffer. And that's sad. But, you know, we try to provide the best home we can for Einstein. And we do support the Wings of Love Bird Haven here in Texas. And we support the Oasis Sanctuary in Arizona. And so, yeah, that's why we decided to get an African cat. We wanted a companion, to answer it in the short answer. We wanted a companion and a pet companion. And so we didn't get a dog. We didn't get a cat. We got a parrot that could be a companion. And he'll be a companion for the rest of our life. And he is in our will. And we will take care of him when we can't, when we can no longer take care of him. And so it's a big, big commitment to own a parrot. And so I've kind of gone off on a soapbox here, but I think most of y'all have heard this from me before. But for those that are new and just joining, that's why we decided to get Einstein. Yes, Haley, African Greys can live to be 50, 60 years old. All parrots live a very, very long time. The smaller the parrot, the shorter the lifespan. But even cockatiels, you know, the little gray and yellow that kind of have yellow on there. There's different mutations, but they can live to be 20, 22 years old. Budgies can live to be 15. So, you know, that's still pretty good. Macaws can live to be 100, 80 to 100. The big macaws. Quakers can live to be 30. So, yeah, that's a consideration. Do your research on the web. If you want to decide to get a parrot and go visit a rescue and rescue, please don't buy from a breeder. There's some good breeders out there, but we have so many parrots in our population. We don't need to be supporting breeders. Back 26 years ago, there was no information about parrot rescues. Like I said, 26 years ago, there wasn't hardly any information on the web. We bought Einstein through a want ad in the newspaper. Remember those? For those of you that are older, there used to be newspapers would have, you know, buy and sell sections, want ads. So yeah, I saw a want ad in the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. That's how we got Einstein. So we found a breeder in Garland, Texas. Had no idea that there were, and I don't even know if there were parrot rescues back then. I don't know. I bet there were, but there just weren't any websites on the web that we could go find out about them. So. I found out about Einstein's cage from an ad in Bird Talk magazine. And they did have a website, and I went to the website, and I had to end up calling them, though, to order the cage, I think, because they didn't have a shopping cart thing on their website. So, you know, in 26 years, we've come a long way as far as technology. And And where did I, let me see, I bought your food, I bought his pellets at a feed store. They had to order them for me. Now I just got, I get them off the web. So it was hard having a parrot. His toys, I did find a website later. I got his toys from a website called Foul Play. They went out of business. So, yeah. You're such a good parrot. Why is he so sleepy? I don't know. He's had a busy morning. He ate a good breakfast and he had a busy morning. Okay. Melanie said you did good finding Einstein. Well, thank you. The breeder that Einstein came from was really good. All the birds grew up in her house. She had a back room and they all grew up back there. And she had cockatoos, macaws, and African greys. And Einstein came from a clutch of three. And Jeff picked him out when, oh golly, Einstein was probably only, well, he was just getting feathers. So Einstein was probably just, three or four weeks old maybe. And they are fully grown and fully feathered and ready to be weaned at about 3 months. And Einstein was weaned and ready to come home at about 3.5 months. By weaned, it means eating on their own, not being syringe fed. Babies are syringe fed when they're young. They're fed a kind of a formula. So he was eating on his own when he came home to us. We still kind of continued the bottle feeding, but he didn't really need it. It was just a comforting thing for him. Oh, thank you, Nancy. Nancy is new to the site and you just love him. Thank you. Well, in case you missed it, we call ourselves the Birdie Brigade, and you don't have to buy anything or do anything to become a member. All you have to do is watch Einstein, subscribe to his YouTube or his Facebook or his Instagram. Just watch him and share him and comment if you're so inclined. Deborah asked, do I have pictures I could share of Einstein as a baby? I do have one. Well, okay, you have to understand this. Back in 1997, there were no cameras on our phones. We didn't even have phones, which is, to carry around with us, which is shocking. at least Jeff and I didn't. We couldn't have, they were still pretty expensive. But we did take film pictures, and cameras weren't so much digital like they were now. They were film cameras. So I do have one picture that I'll show y'all here in a minute. I have to run and get it. But there are other pictures on his website. And if you go to EinsteinParrot.com, go through the menu. I think it's /photos. Yeah, I know it is. It's /photos. And there are a lot of pictures there. Let me go get this picture that we have of him. This picture is on the web, on that site. It's probably one of the very first pictures we have of Einstein. And this picture frame, at the time I was in a gift business. I owned a gift business, and I found this at market. And I don't believe these are available anymore. It's been 26 years. So that's a picture of baby Einstein. And so let me post the links I've been talking about. Photos. I don't know, I can't remember now, but okay, how long have we been on here? Oh gosh, it's almost time to leave. I don't like to go longer than 40, 45 minutes on these streams, just because I know y'all have other things to do and I've got things to do. Okay, go to EinsteinParrot.com. And all about Einstein. And then go to my photos. Yep, and the first picture that comes up is Einstein as a baby. So there's other pictures there. Whoops. Yeah, it's EinsteinParrot.com/photos. And I just posted the link. There's any other things that I mentioned that you want links to, just put them in the comments. Put your questions in the comments and I'll get back to you. Oh, Billy, I answered that. Einstein had two other siblings. We don't know what happened to them. The breeder wouldn't tell us. And also, somewhere on Facebook, well, I know it's easier to find on YouTube. Things are so hard to find on Facebook once they get posted. But do a Google search for Einstein the early days. Einstein Parrot early days. Let me look that up. And you'll find all kinds of videos, even a playlist of some of his early talking and everything that we recorded with my dad's camcorder. And then later we had to convert that to another format. It's a pain in the butt to do, but we did it anyway. Wait just a second. I can't talk and do this. Einstein Parrot. Early days. Yeah. There's, and you spell days like D-A-Y-S. I've spelled it, you know, the normal way. But there's a bunch of videos, and you'll recognize them by Einstein being in a baby carriage, okay? And there are several parts. There's like four or five parts. And they're easily located on YouTube. So give those a watch. They're not very long. Each of them is only like maybe 10, 12 minutes long. But you'll get a glimpse of Einstein when he was much younger. Oh, I'm sorry. This is what they look like. Okay. So only three are shown here. But so anyway, yeah, so this has just been a question and answer session because Einstein's been kind of sleepy. So I enjoyed it, though. I think you learned a lot about Einstein if you didn't know. And go watch Einstein as a baby. Like I said, these are all videos and pictures after he came home. Okay, because we didn't even think to bring a camera to the breeders. I mean, like I said, all we had was film camera, and we just didn't have phones like we have, our cameras like we have now. So, oh, good. Sandra watches Einstein on YouTube too. Good. Thank you. Yeah, I pretty much post the same content on both platforms. So yeah, that's great. Okay, everybody, I'm not going to be going live tomorrow because I need to get some things done around here. I need to do some cleaning and some catching up. So no live stream tomorrow. We don't do one on Saturday, but we'll be back here on Sunday. Sunday at 2:00 Central. We always are on YouTube and Facebook at the same time. And we'll just look forward to seeing y'all then, okay? Okay, if you have any other questions, just let me know in the comments and I'll get back to you. Thanks a bunch. See y'all on Sunday. Bye-bye.